the big challenge with today's light water reactors is that we want to extend their life. They're reaching the end of their license, but not their useful life. That means that the materials are going to be exposed to higher and higher levels of damage. The outcome of this work is really addressing two major issues with regard to energy. One is keeping our light water reactors operational past their original license period. That's important because in the US, nuclear reactors and nuclear energy is about 20% of our electricity, but more importantly, it's most of our carbon-free electricity. We lose that, we lose our carbon-free advantage in this country. The second issue is being able to use these accelerators to qualify materials for advanced reactor concepts. And those advanced reactors are important because, first, they're more economical, they're safer, they produce less waste than conventional reactors, and they represent the future of an energy source, which again is carbon-free and very robust in terms of lifetime and economics. The community is also looking at new advanced reactor types, fast reactors, where the radiation damage in cores is even higher levels. And those damage levels are very difficult to achieve in test reactors. In fact, in the US, we don't have test reactors to get to these levels that we need to get to so that we can understand how materials are going to behave. So our approach to this is to use ion accelerators, like the one sitting behind me here. What we do is we simulate radiation effects in a reactor using this accelerator. We simulate the temperatures that can cause damage at higher damage rates. And so the challenge is trying to figure out how to conduct an irradiation such that the resulting structure looks the same after our irradiations as it does in a reactor. If we can do that, we'll be able to attack these problems much, much quicker and develop materials and new concepts much quicker. In fact, it'll almost be impossible to do so without the ability to use accelerators like this to accelerate the radiation damage phenomena. But we can't simulate everything with one accelerator. Turns out we need multiple accelerators, actually three in total. Because under irradiation, the major things that occur are two. One, we create damage by displacing atoms. And two, we create new materials, new isotopes, by transmutation reactions. So this accelerator can create the damage. We need another accelerator to implant the species that occurs by transmutation in a reactor. So we're redesigning this laboratory to accommodate three accelerators, the one behind me, the one in front of me, and a brand new one that we'll be receiving in November of 2013. And the objective is to make a national user facility out of this laboratory where we can conduct very high fidelity radiation damage experiments to capture all the elements of a reactor core and make these experiments then applicable to future concepts or life extension for light water reactors.